Привет, друзья! Как дела? My name is Fedor, and today you will learn the difference between и, но, and а. All three of these are used to put a complex sentence together, and these three things will kind of combine the complex sentence and will have a connection between one part and the second part. Let's start with и and break it down and explain when it's used. И means and, but the distinction between an English and the Russian E is that Russian E is only used when we put two of the same things into one. We kind of are showing their similarity. Okay, so in a simple sentence, it can be Я люблю рис и картошку. I love rice and potatoes. So you are putting рис and картошка, rice and potatoes, into one category of things that I love. So you want to combine them into one category with this и. И is also used in a complex sentence. Something like this. Он снял этот фильм и спродюсировал его. He shot this movie and he produced it. So in this sentence, we use и because we want to show the kind of similarity between two actions. Right? So he shot it and he produced it. So we are showing that the same person did two things. And that's why we use и in this sentence. Because it's one and the same category. We're not saying, we're not opposing anything. So we're just simply combining two actions into one using a conjunction и. Now, но is but. Let's talk about но a little bit. Но means but. And once again, the difference between but in English and но is that no is only used to contrast things, to show how different they are, to kind of oppose them between each other, to show that they're not the same, okay? And no is only used in a complex sentence. So if we use the same exact example with a person shooting and producing, it can be something like this. Он снял этот фильм, но он его не спродюсировал. He shot this movie, but he did not produce it. So in this sentence, we are opposing two actions. Him shooting and him producing it. He did not produce it. And we want to show that. We want to show that contrast that he did one thing, but didn't do another with a conjunction no. Right? So we are opposing two parts of a sentence to kind of show the differences. That this person did this, but he did not do this. So we are opposing two parts using но, right? And но is only used for this kind of sentences. We cannot use it for anything else. Now we are finally getting to а. А can be translated as while. А, an interesting thing about а is that it's used just as frequently as и and но. But it kind of has a meaning that's somewhere in between of combining two things and opposing them. А is used when two parts of a sentence are not similar or opposite. They're simply different, right? So for example, we can say он снял этот фильм, а я его спродюсировал. He shot this movie and I produced it, or while I produced it. They're not the opposite, right? Him shooting and me producing is not the same. No, it's not the opposite either. So we use а in this case. So а is used to kind of put different statements together into one big sentence. Once again, we are not using it to oppose anything. We are not using it to combine anything either. Now, the very difficult part of this и, но, and а is that in English, when we have to use I in Russian, in English we can use but and. For example, in the same exact sentence. Он снял фильм, а я его спродюсировал. He shot a movie while I produced it. We can say he shot a movie but I produced it. We can also say he shot a movie and I produced it. All three of these sentences will be correct. And that's when the confusion comes for you guys who are English speakers or who learn English and are learning Russian, is that it's not clear, right? It's not clear for you exactly when to use а, because in your language you can use and but. But you have to kind of stop for a second and ask yourself a question. These two parts of a sentence, are they are talking about the same thing? So I have to use E to combine them into one? Are they opposite and I have to use NOR to oppose them? Or they're simply different and I have to use I? That's the question that you have to ask for you to be correct. But also, something else that you can be doing is that you simply, when you read other things, when you read other stories, you watch other maybe videos and somebody is using E, NO, and A, just simply pay close attention which context they are used in. And kind of develop slowly but surely develop a feel for all three of them. And that's going to be the best strategy because you are learning from natives, and that's the best way to go about learning new things, is looking at the way natives do it and just borrowing that. That's it. Continue learning the Great Russian language with this next video.